The Bras Basah complex is bounded by North Bridge Road, Victoria Street, Bain Street and Cashin Street. One quarter of the Bras Basah complex is used as a shopping complex, while the other three quarters is used as a residential area.
这边曾经是新加坡新谣的诞生地，新谣就在当时那个校园歌曲也都曾经一度很流行，那我们这边是它的发源地，它曾经以前我们通常拜六哦，在这边哦都会举办一些演唱会，啊那个新谣就在这边开始，哦当时那个新谣来这边演唱，整个百盛楼都挤满了人。 所以你如果是问那些现在大概是四十多岁的人，他们就会有这个记忆。这个是已经有三十多年的历史了。一开始这个大厦一开始就是以书店哦为主。百盛楼呢本身就是从过去的年代啊。 这个传统的书店街，这个街呢就是小波大马路，就是在我们白城楼这条街。以前这个 Bras Basah 呢，就是在我们隔壁的那条街，国泰线过来的这条街叫做 Bras Basah。后来因为那边是有很多英文书店，但是没有中文书店。 中文书店传统的中文书店都是集中在这个百盛楼，就是小波大马路。因为以前的这个华文书店都是比较集中，集中的书店呢就比较容易经营啊。因为你假设你不集中的话呢，东一间西一间呢，比如说中华书记在七木街，世界书记在大波大马路，所以就不集中。 所以生意基本上是受影响了，但是这一段的历史呢，这个是比较热闹一点，而且书店都是集中，你这些买不到的话，隔壁另外一间可以买得到。
Interestingly, I've been there recently, compared to about 30 years ago. Okay, it was it's quite similar actually inside the complex. Yeah. In fact even the shops themselves, like Popular, are still there. And I think if I'm not wrong, Union Bookstore is still there. Right. And a few music shops are still there. You know. So in fact, there's this place where we used to buy calculators from, it's still there.
I think it's all right. Not very crowded, but people like to come here for the books.
这里啊，礼拜天忙得上，因为有图书馆嘛。平时呢就比较近一点。For
us it's popular, but for now youngster, I don't think so because quite a number of youngster don't know there is such a complex here.
不算是很热闹。一方面来讲，现在看书的人也比较少。
I think there's a different mix of crowd, that's for sure. Because before that, there was actually St. Nicholas. There's a Catholic High. There's a lot of schools there actually. I think St. Anthony Convent, right? So all these schools are no longer there. So you tend to see a lot less students. It used to be crowded with students. Yeah, it used to be a place where actually a lot of students hang out. In fact, every now and then we actually above the Bras Basah complex, actually the residential area. There wasn't any field there actually. So we used to play plastic ball, right? Above. Actually, in the not in the complex, yeah, but on the roof area, yeah.
Yeah, I visit libraries quite often because you don't need to pay to borrow the books, but here you need to buy the books and they cost money. I prefer libraries, but e-books I don't quite like because you got to read them off a screen.
还是喜欢看到那个实际的那个书来翻，因为传统嘛。 我还是比如来讲，虽然我有看电子书，我也用 iPad。不过一看到华文呢，我还是用看书，比较眼睛没有那么累。I
think it will definitely. I have a feeling they might take this tear down this complex sooner or later because of all these libraries and e-books coming up.
Yes, definitely it will affect, because now youngsters all using IT technology, they seldom want to carry a book in hand. So there's a decreasing in the whole lah.
我相信生意接下来应该会受影响啊，因为在主要一点是年轻的，他们都懂得使用电脑，通常都是上网去看那个电子书。不过传统的这些书本还是会有人要，因为毕竟感觉不一样，就好像看报纸一样，你也可以上网去看新闻，但是报纸还是存在，只是可能会是没有不能够像以前这样的普遍。
Personally, I would like it to stay for a long time because it's quite unique. You don't get a complex where you have so many bookshops around. Everybody knows they come here for secondhand books. So it's a nice place, very cozy place. People like to come here, so I would come back here again.
他们的未来是应该是很大的挑战，除非能够鼓励阅读华语的人越来越多，不然的话是相当的挑战。 相当的挑战，因为你可以看到一间一间的书局已经是关了，而且现在的这边呢，如果你看到能够生存的那个书店呢，一般都是走向那个教儿童的教育方面。那么如果是属于文化的啦，或者非文学类版的，已经是越来越小，可以从这个每一年的那个书展也看得到越来越小哟。
We hope that the government will do something on it, because this is the only building in Singapore which is the whole building selling books and stationery, which is quite a memory building. So we hope that government will put it under a conservative status, and not to demolish this place.
这个生意是非常差的，这个不是。 生意的问题是我们的文化教育的问题，我们的新的一代的年轻人都没有都很少读华文，而且华文的改革，跟这个英文为教学没意义的话，第二语文的是中文，所以大家都不重视这个华文，所以对华文的学习来讲是几年以后慢慢的。 走下坡来了。我们做华文书店有两个目的的，一个呢是为了生存，一个呢是为了负这个使命，负这个华文使命，所以我们这两个问题，我们也一方面也是生存，只是我们一旦生存不下去的话，连我们的使命也不能完成了。
We will try our utmost to attract those youngsters to come back to these places. Now we try to upgrade the whole complex and maybe be a more modernized.
我是认为那个百盛楼也要随着时代的改变而改变了。那我们这边来讲，需要多举办一些文化活动，或者有关那个艺术方面的一些活动。 我们现在在进行一个翻新，跟好什么配合合作，做一个翻新，改善一些设施。我们希望这边来讲，增添一点多一点文化色彩，包括一些会举办一些活动。